A million years is a very long time to us, but when you think about how old the universe is, 13.8 billion years old, it's really not that long. That being said, a lot can happen in a million years. Our moon used to be much closer to us a million years ago, and would have looked much larger in the night sky. Species have come and went, and humans have only been around for about 1 million years. But what about 1 million years in the future? What will happen? That's the question we're asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that questions the impossible. I'm your host, Charlotte Dobre, and hit that thumbs up button if you love videos about space. By the way, if you love our SCP videos, how can you not? Check out our latest one by Jack Finch, What If SCP-682 Was Real? That's currently clickable on your screen right now. It is extremely difficult to predict the future, but according to scientific understanding that we currently have, this is what will happen in a million years. We've already covered what will happen to the Earth in 1 million years' time in our video, What Will the Earth Look Like in 1 million Years? If you haven't seen that, check it out, it's clickable on the screen right now. But the Earth is not the center of the universe, so let's explore this topic a little more. It is believed that in 1 million years, the Earth will likely have undergone a supervolcanic eruption, big enough to erupt 32,000 kilometers of magma. This eruption will be comparable to the Toba super eruption that took place 75,000 years ago. The Toba super eruption occurred in Lake Toba in Sumatra, Indonesia. It caused a global volcanic winter that was 6 to 10 years long and a 1,000 year cooling episode. It's also likely that the Yellowstone supervolcano will also erupt sometime in the next 1 million years. In 1 million years, Uranus's moons, Desdemona and Cressida, will have collided. In fact, over the course of 1 million years, the sun and stars will have moved enough that the current constellations will be scrambled and will look extremely different. As time goes on, it's going to become extremely likely that the Earth will be bombarded by some sort of asteroid or comet, maybe even several asteroids or comets. This is because in a million years from now, another star is going to enter our solar system. The star is called Gilles 710. It's an orange dwarf star, classified as a rogue star, which roams around the galaxy free of gravitational chains. Gilles 710 is going to get as close as 0.14 light years to the sun before it moves away. But because the star is going to get so close, it's going to pass through the Oort cloud. The Oort cloud is a ring of icy and rocky objects that orbit our solar system. The Oort cloud was named after the astronomer who first theorized its existence, Jan Oort. It's hypothesized that the Oort cloud is where most long-period comets have come from. It could be that the Oort cloud is a halo of particles that's actually made up of the remains of the disk of material that formed the sun and our planets in our solar system. Because the Oort cloud is so far away, it's possible for it to be disrupted by the nearby passage of a star, sending objects into the inner solar system. While the star Gilles 710 passes through the Oort cloud, that's going to increase the likelihood of cometary impact in the inner solar system, and quite possibly, the Earth. A cometary impact will most definitely cause mass extinction on Earth. It might not end all life on Earth, but it will be very, very bad for all the life forms that are still around on our planet in 1 million years. Of course, while Gilles 710 is getting close to us, the skies are going to be lit up by yet another star other than our sun. This has actually happened before. Our sun has a close encounter with 490 to 600 other stars every 1 million years. So what about humans during all of this? A million years from now, if humans are still around, we will likely have merged with technology to form bionic beings. We probably won't look anything like what we currently look like. In fact, according to experts, humans will be unrecognizable 1 million years from now. A million years from now, humans will have gained a complete understanding of our universe by uniting all theoretical equations to create a unified theory. In a million years, our sun won't really change all that much, but it will start to get hotter. Looking even further, in 1 to 2 billion years, the sun will boil our oceans and end all life on Earth. The Andromeda Galaxy, as well as the Triangulum Galaxy, will have merged with our galaxy in 4 billion years' time. This will effectively change the structure of the Milky Way galaxy as we know it, making one giant galaxy. Let's call it Milkdromeda. Our sun is expected to go supernova in 5 to 7 billion years, so say goodbye to both Venus and Mercury. The Earth will then become the closest planet to the sun, but it will be pushed outwards, so it won't be engulfed. Well, there you have it. Does anyone else get anxiety when they're talking about space? Let's change the subject and respond to some of your comments. Hamish said, what if I had friends? Aw, we're your friends, Hamish, forever and always. Vizard Girl said, what if people didn't exist? This is actually a pretty good question. I would think that the world would be in much better better shape and there would be way more animals than there currently are. As a 29 said, oh my god, you just hit a million. We hit a million a couple weeks ago actually, but thanks again to all our subscribers for helping us reach this milestone. Damon German said, another awesome video by another amazing channel. Love both your channels, they are awesome. Thanks so much Damien, glad you like our content. Welcome to the end screen, this means the video is over. If you want to continue watching, there's a playlist currently flashing on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on those notifications so I can see you in the next LBQ video.